Hey guys, it's Broiler here, and thanks for tuning into this video. If you have me on your Steam friends list, then you know that it's no secret that I spend a lot of time on Steam. Steam is by far my favorite gaming platform, with tons of games, a mostly great and helpful community, and a lot of other stuff to do. However, while Steam is huge, it's still a very lingering question. What games should I at least try out from the ever so massive list of games that Steam has to offer? Well, fear not, as I may or may not have the answer to this question. Today, we will be taking a look at the top 10 games on Steam. Before I begin the countdown, I just want to point out that this entire list is my opinion and what I think you should at least try out. You may disagree with my choices, but please do not criticize me for my choices, as it is all my opinion and not your opinion. Another thing that I would want to point out is that depending on when you're viewing this video, the list may or may not be outdated, though if you're watching this a year after it's been released, then it's pretty safe to assume that the views of this video, like my views of the top 10 games, have completely changed since this video. With that out of the way, let's begin this countdown! Orion Prelude had a really, really bumpy start in which it gained a lot of backlash and negativity. Even to this day, there are a lot of people that sincerely hate this game like it's the spawn of Satan himself. But is it really that bad? No. No, it's not. Orion Prelude is a very cheap indie first-person shooter where you team up with four other players to survive waves of dinosaurs. The game also offers some PvP and has Steam Workshop support. While arguably the game's textures are considerably low quality and it's riddled with all sorts of bugs like frame rate drops and some collision detection issues, for the price I really think all of that can be overlooked. With it being just a mere 79 cents, I really think what you're getting for the price is more than worth it. Orion Prelude is a fun co-op shooter that can be played with random people, friends, or even with bots, and I honestly don't think you should pass this game up. I'm gonna get a lot of backlash for this one. Counter-Strike Nexon Zombies is a free-to-play Counter-Strike game where the main attraction is, well, zombies. Of course, with it being a free-to-play game, it's expected that the game has microtransactions. But is the game bad? Not really. At least not to me. Counter-Strike Nexon Zombies offers a lot of game modes to ensure that you never really get bored, has a decent crafting system, and a huge player base for a free-to-play game. You can even play the original Counter-Strike completely free of charge, and it can run on a potato of a computer. It's a decently nice distraction if you want to do something else than you usually do. I personally aren't a huge fan of tower defense games, but Super Sanctum TD is the one tower defense game that I find myself coming back to from time to time. In this game, you select a set number of turrets, place them on blocks, and then start the wave and watch your turrets destroy the hordes of enemies coming to destroy your core. You can buy upgrades for your turrets too, which increase its stats, and use power-ups to help your turrets fight the insane amounts of enemies coming at you. Coupled with great music, appealing 16-bit graphics, and easy to get into gameplay for the price, I think you're getting a lot out of this game. If it's on a sale, definitely pick this game up. Planetariumはいかがでしょう? Steam is notorious for having really, really shitty visual novels, a la Sacred Spirit and Rising Angels Reborn. But Planetarian is one novel that I can definitely recommend. Granted, this is not for everyone. There is very little gameplay other than reading and clicking on your mouse all the time. I would really recommend this game only to anime fans and people who want a decent visual novel. Short but touching story, fantastic music, great art design, and amazing sound composition, Planetarian, Reverie of a Little Planet is by far one of the best visual novels to be released on Steam. Craft, mine, build, fight. All of these sound like Minecraft, right? Well, it can all be applied to Terraria as well. Terraria is a simple yet complex game offering you to do a lot of things. The aforementioned crafting, building, fighting, etc. It's pretty amazing how much depth this game has. With seemingly infinite possibilities, great developers, lots of content, and simply perfect music and difficulty, Terraria is one of the best games, in my opinion, to come out on Steam. Still waiting for Half-Life 3, Valve. The sequel to the record-breaking game, Half-Life, Half-Life 2 is a really good game to pick up and play. It's really hard to say stuff about Half-Life 2 that hasn't been said already. Great graphics for a 2004 game, amazing mod support, very flexible game engine, and a great story coupled with great gameplay. Half-Life 2 is one of those games that any fan of first-person shooters should really try out. That's about as much as I can say about this game. You really need to play it to understand a lot more about it. Trust me on this one.
Remaining urban centers.
Attention. This tower is detected.
Possibly the cheapest game on Steam at times, rocking it at a whopping 9 cents, Defy Gravity Extended is a game very often overlooked because of its pretty poor graphics and kind of bad optimization, but in truth, Defy Gravity is a very unique game where you use a gravity gun of some sorts to maneuver over platforms and other things. With great music, solid controls, and a short but decent campaign, I think Defy Gravity is a game that does not overstate its welcome, and remains really fun to play. I'm not sure how my list can be complete without a Need for Speed game. Need for Speed Hot Pursuit is a racing game released in 2010, which provides a decently long campaign of both cop and racer over a very huge game world. Coupled with decent car control, fun gameplay, amazing graphics, and very nice audio design, Need for Speed Hot Pursuit is so far one of the best racing games to be released on Steam. Far surpassing something like The Crew, at least in my opinion. Just my personal preference, guys. I'm sorry, just don't hate me for my preference, okay? Okay, good, thanks. One of the most played games on Steam, I really, really don't know how anyone could leave the classic TF2 out of this list. with an insanely active online community after almost 8 years. Lots of update, great developer support, and a very, very in-depth item system. Team Fortress 2 is the game that will hook you for hours on end, constantly getting new weapons, hats, finding custom game modes by the community, crafting, trading, etc. It's really a game that everyone on Steam should at least try out once, and I don't think you'll be disappointed with it. For a free-to-play game, that is a lot of fucking content right there. And before I go to reveal my number one pick, let me just give my honorable mentions.
Often I am asked, what does a hero truly need?
Pretend like you didn't see this one coming. Probably my favorite game of all time, Counter-Strike Global Offensive is a competitive first-person shooter offering a variety of different game modes, both official and community-made, lots of gorgeous-looking skins for you to spend all your money on, and of course the constantly growing community. With being ranked the number 2 most played game on Steam, and my personal favorite game as of January 2015, this game offers amazing gameplay, simply perfect audio design, great visuals, and an ever-growing and thriving community. Counter-Strike Global Offensive will forever stand as one of the most played games on Steam and one of my personal favorite games ever. I have never played a game that hooked me a lot more than CSGO. Seriously, if it's on a sale, buy CSGO. Even if it's not a sale, on a sale, just save up money and get CSGO. It's so fucking good, just get it, okay? Okay, it's good, thank you. And that just about wraps up this video. Please remember that this entire list was completely my opinion and is based off the games that I played and enjoyed the most. If a game you think was really good but wasn't on this list, then it's most likely because I haven't played it yet or didn't enjoy it as much. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.